What it do, Libras? Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Girl King. Happy fabulous Friday, Libras. Feeling a little jazzy? Feeling a little game showish? Get it, Libra. Get it, Libra. Libras, sun, moon, rising, north, no, wherever Libra may be sprinkled in your chart, you are welcome here. Libras, happy fantabulous Friday. Got a surprise for you, Libras. We're going to play, as you can hear by the game show music in the background, and for some of you old heads, you know what game show this is. One of my faves. Libras, we're going to play Plinko Drinko Tarot. So we're going to let the drop of the coin decide our fate. Or at least the energies for today. We're going to let the drop of these pentacles see what the story is. So some of all of these messages, Libra, may or may not resonate with you in this current passage of moments. So of course, please do only take the messages that vibrate with you. If it's not vibrating for you, Libra, then maybe it's not what it do. We're gonna switch up the music here and see what's popping. How you doing, Libras? How's your day? Are you feeling sexy? Some of y'all woke up smiling in the AM. Some of you woke up with a smile on your face. Some of you were dancing in the shower this morning. So I heard. All right, Libras, let's see what's popping. What's your energy, shall we? So we're going to place a few decks down here, and we're going to let the decks, of course, tell the story. So already someone doesn't want anyone else to get a piece of your love, Libra. Interesting. Let's mix it up here. So we've got six cups, so we'll put six decks down here. We'll ask some questions. We'll get some answers. We'll see what happens. It's all an experiment, Libra. Right? What else do we have here? Where's my other deck? Okay. So we're going to start with some tarot and some kids against maturity mixed in here. And again, we'll see what happens, Libra. Right now, I have shuffled these decks before. So we're gonna save some time and not shuffle those again. So let's see, Libras. Angels, what's popping for my Libras today? What's popping for my Libras? Look at that, Libra. Okay, so the third one. So we have the Ten of Cups in reverse. So we've got some water energy out here, Libra. What's going on? You're gathering all your cups, Libra. You're gathering all your cups. Is that why you're smiling? Because newness is coming in, a new beginning. So you're seeing things in a different way. So it's not that love isn't coming to you. It's just that you're seeing love in a new way. Your perception has changed. So you've been gathering all of your cups. What I've been talking about, Libra. You've been gathering all of your cups, saving them and storing them up. Cups of all different elements. You've got somebody wide open, Libra. Oh, snap. Number three again. Here we go. So 33 could be significant. We have these six. I'm sorry, the Six of Pentacles in reverse. So we've got Taurus energy. Something's growing. Something's shifting. Something shifted for you last night. I don't know what happened last summer. I know what you did last summer, Libra. Anyways, something happened for you last night. There was a shift for you last night. For some of you, while you were asleep. Some of you, for some strange odd reason, did not sleep, or you didn't sleep as peacefully as you normally do or you have been. Because there was a literal shift last night for you, Libra. Now, this could have had something to do with this Taurus. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe a Taurus has shifted around you. You live in rent-free in somebody's mind, Libra. The song playing right now is Rent Free by Black. What's getting stuck? That's the heart chakra. We'll just tap it. No? Can we shake it? Okay, number four. Well, interesting. So what is going on? Plunger. Somebody's stuck. This Taurus is stuck. Stuck between a rock and a hard place. Because see, while you over here scooping up all your energy and all your cups, Libra, gathering all your beautiful cups that you've been pouring upon yourself that you are now possibly ready to offer to the world. And this Taurus, look what's on here. Is this the scales on the Pentacles card? So, yes, you and this Taurus, Libra, they're talking about you. Boy, they are gathering up their Pentacles because things are not balanced with this Taurus. Again, they're stuck in between a rock and a hard place. They're trying to unfuck themselves from something or someone. Because, Libra, you've been living rent-free. Rent-free. You ain't paid not a goddamn dime, Libra, to live rent-free in this Taurus's mind. What else is going on, angels? Let's see. What's that over here? Number two. Someone here could be 42. We have Yule Log. What happened at Christmas? Someone tried to serve you up a hot plate of shit. You said, you're not even Santa Claus. Quit playing. We don't take these kind of presents. Look at your face, Libra. Look at your face. You were like, I don't take these kind of presents. This looks like a hot plate of shit. And it sure was. A hot Yule Log. Also, someone was pissed off around Christmas, Libra. Someone put you on the cold list. So someone decided to take back some shit. They didn't want to play Santa Claus to you. They didn't want to gift you or give you anything. So they put you on the list to receive a bag of coal. But it wasn't a bag of coal this person wanted to give you. No, they wanted to give you shit on a silver platter. That's not how we do this. Look at the reservation in your face. Someone could be making reservations. Someone could be planning something with you. Because some shit got fucked up at Christmas. What happened, Libra? Again, because you weren't accepting shit. And now this Taurus looks like they're having to see it your way, Libra. There was a shift at Christmas, possibly for this Taurus. But there was definitely, Libra, a shift for you last night. Look at that number. Was that two? TextNet. Oh, this person. Did you lose contact, Libra? Did you lose contact? Maybe, maybe not. But this person definitely has text neck. So this person is either missing being in contact with you and or this person has hurt their neck, literally bending their neck backwards or forwards to get a better look at you. This person spends a lot of time looking at you online. Hey, that rhymes. Tragic is what it is, Libra. It's Tragic by Jasmine Sullivan is playing right now. It's tragic that this person has literally hurt their neck, Libra. This person has hurt their neck. Listen, that was the the yellow chip falling on the floor. So this person's whole solar plexus is fucked up. Their neck and their back. No, their stomach and their neck. Oh, Libra, there are some people around them that are definitely aware, family members, friends, like, God dang, man, you fucked up. Look at this crook in their neck. They could literally have a crook in their neck. Libra, I don't feel like you had a crook in your neck, even though you might not have slept as peacefully as possible. last night, but this person definitely is looking to have had some permanence of text neck. Replay, Libra. This person is on replay. Listen, it's tragic. They just got you on replay. You're living rent-free in their mind. My God, solar plexus, stomach, all fucked up. Fell out on the floor, Libra. Look at this. It don't, Get it together. Number three, what we got? Look at that, Libra. Is that the Eight of Wands? Is that communication coming in, Libra? Oh, shucky ducky. That's Sagittarius energy there, Libra. Swooping on in. So there could be communication coming in from a Sag. Interesting. All these people who want to unstick and unfuck themselves from certain situations having to do with you. So we're going to reshift these now. We know what the storyline is. We'll start asking some questions. Questions, Libra. Everybody's got questions, and gosh damn it, they want answers. You seem to be the only one to answer the questions, Libra. Let's see what else is going on. Oh, it's gonna get interesting. I can feel it. What else? We'll pick this out here. I'll check and see what else is going on with this situation. Get some more signs. Let's get it. Oh, the chipset. We have the initials N-I-R, could be your initials, this person's initials. Someone wants to get near you, Libra. All right, let's see what's going on. Number one, so someone is disappointed. Could be a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. We have a lot of water energy here. Someone is disappointed, Libra. Disappointed, boy. They got a whole mouthful to say. They don't even know how to say it. So bothered, Libra. So bothered, so disappointed that you've taken all those cups up. That you've gathered them all up for yourself. That you're seeing love in a new direction. In a new light. You're taking love in a new direction. You're taking your emotions in a new direction. Some of y'all have been traveling in the ethers heavily. What else? It's a draw. We'll take it. So we have 4 and 5. 45. Someone's got a gun. Someone's got a gun. Oh. So this is the replay, because I'm going to have to replay that chip. Yeah, this replay that this person wants to have. So we have fire and earth energy. We have swing. It says, I'm a dude playing a dude disguised as another dude from Tropic Thunder. Oh, there's been an emotional storm in this person's finances. This Taurus, because they were wearing a disguise. This person might have been wearing a disguise to get closer to you, Libra. They might have acted like you, or I just heard mimicked you. So however you were behaving, whatever things you talked about, of course, this person talked about, but it was like mimicking. It wasn't... There was just a spin. There was a lot of spin. You know, spin, like when someone's explaining something to you, but they put their own twist, they put their own spin on the story. There was a lot of spinning. There's these pentacles right now. They're spinning. Things are out of balance, out of whack. This person might have been a swinger. They're swinging all around town, just... Y'all remember back in the day when you used to swing on the swings and you would swing as high as you could swing and, you know, you try and get up the gust, the nerve, the courage to jump off. So this person feels like this is a new jump off with you. Like they want to return, they want to rewind. This person knows that they were wearing a disguise in the past. What else, Angus? Number four. We have magnet. Yeah, there's a lot of earth energy here. Someone is really trying to get grounded. This person is utilizing creative visualization. They're trying to manifest you back, Libra. This person is trying to pull you back in because they don't want to be in this stuck-ass energy anymore. For some reason, this person is stuck like Chuck. Someone's name could be Chuck. So they could manifest you for hours and hours, Libra. They could just spend a whole lifetime manifesting you back, trying to pull you back in to unstick, unstuck, unfuck themselves from a situation that I feel like for some of you, this Taurus, this Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio may have put themselves in. If this person is wanting to speak up, we have the Eight of Wands. That's communication coming in rather quickly, Libra. Solar plexus again. You see that? That yellow? They can't quite get it to drop. They can't quite get that stomach together. Boy, what is going on? Look at the yellow. Boy, there's solar plexus, Libra. This person may be having an identity crisis right now. They're trying to get themselves together, but all they can do is think about you. They're hurting themselves, Libra. They're hurting their whole neck, their whole stomach, thinking about you. They want to come in with this communication. Now, this could be a new sign, a new energy. Like I said, it could be a Sagittarius wanting to come in with this fire, this passion. To explain some things to you. It says they may take our lives, but they will never take our freedom. So this person was afraid of commitment. This person was afraid of taking this action, going on this adventure, this journey with you. From Braveheart, this person did not have a brave heart. They were not willing to take this risk. And now this person is trying very desperately to ground themselves, to balance themselves out. Because again, we have the scales on this Seven of Pentacles. So they're trying to flip some shit to get their balance, their world, their finances, things in the physical back together. This person again knows that you are a brave heart. This is air energy. What else, Angels? So undecided. Undecided. It says, I appreciate this whole seduction thing you've got going on here, but let me give you a tip. I'm a sure thing. Listen, gosh damn it. This person tried to seduce you, and now this person feels seduced by you because you have left them the fuck alone. You scooped up all your cups, Libra. He said, the fuck out of here. Let me get this one and this one and this one. Matter of fact, let me take all these bitches back. Libra, this, listen. It's the sign of the times. They said that all things shall be revealed. All things done in the dark will come to the light. And boy, if this isn't the age of enlightenment, illumination, things coming out of the dark. Libra, you're such a pretty woman. 1990 could be significant. You or this person could have been born in 1990. It says, I do wish we could chat longer, but I'm having an old friend for dinner. Libra, you may be moving on, and it could be this Sagittarius coming in. Because you can't be silenced, Libra. See, you can control your emotions, even when people think your shit is flipped upside down. No, that's just you stocking up those reserves, and people thought you was falling all over the place, like your whole world is like, oh my god, like the hands open, like, oh my god. No. You were hunting and gathering all your motherfucking cups back up, because that's where they are, right? They're up, but, you know, they're pointing down, but they're up. You feel me? Libra, this cutoff game you got going on here, the way that you were able to just disappear some people as if they never even existed at all. God damn, you got people's whole world shaking up. Body, mind, and spirit. You live in rent-free in people's minds. You have their equilibrium fucked off. Because they wanted to wear a disguise. It's not your fault. You're making new plans. You're done with the drama, and that's why this love is coming in, because you've reined in your emotions. You know how to handle the ebb and flow of the universe. You're in control of your energy. You know when and where to place your cups. But you're also not afraid to take them back when necessary. The silence of the lambs. Yeah, Libra, almost said Leo. This is that Leo energy that is still hanging about from the full moon in Leo, the snow moon. Boy, it is snowing like cats and dogs for people. Number four. Peanut butter. So this Sagittarius is going to open their mouth, this Taurus, this Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Because you got this air, you got this water, this earth, and this fire. All the elements are coming for your air, Libra. Do you understand? They're ready to get unstuck. Yeah, they want to just bust that top off the peanut butter jar. They don't want to be stuck. They want to uncover all that stickiness, that gooiness. I just heard repair. Someone here could be a repairman. This person very much, again, Libra, wants to repair some things with you. What else? So, 3 and 4. It says, give me that baby, you warthog from hell, from Raising Arizona. Someone could be in Arizona with me. I don't know. This person was raised in the desert, I just heard. Why are these... Listen. Yeah, because what I say, this is why there's extras. I was like, why are there... extra stacks, yeah, because some of these need to be on replay. This person is trying to change their darkness. This person may have gone through a dark night of the soul, because the two that we had to replay are the black chip and the green chip, so the heart chakra and a little bit of darkness. All these things coming to the light. All this earth energy. Boy, this person wants to really take you out, Libra. They this person might want to put a baby in you. This person wants to see your wild side. This is who is this? Normani and Cardi B. Person may want to take you camping, but they want to take you away from your house, Libra, and do some deeds to you in the forest. This person wants to get lost with you again, the wild side. Where do you go with a tent? Take it outside into the great unknown, right? This person wants to step into the great unknown with you. They want to see your wild side. Give me that baby, you warthog from hell. Ooh, someone likes a little bit rough. Yeah, someone's been on this desert journey, so they're a little bit dry, Libra. So this person may not have entertained anyone in quite some time. Libra, you may not have entertained someone for quite some time. When someone is ready to raise the desert, they're ready to let the waters flow, Libra. Number three, what is going on? It says, the saddest thing in life is wasted talent. You or this person could be from New York, 1993, could be significant. This person doesn't want to waste this opportunity with you, Libra. This person doesn't want to continue to be in this flow of drama. You know what they just showed me? Like, you know, when you're swimming and, like, you're having a good time, but, like, you come to that point, you've been in the water so long, and it's like, okay, I'm ready to get out. Like, I'm ready to get out right now. And then, you know, you climb yourself out of the pool. So this person has been in their emotions because you've captured and controlled your emotions. And so now this person is trying to do the same thing. They've reined in their emotions, and now they're ready to get out of the water. Out of the drama. They know how talented you are, Libra. And they feel like not being with you would be a wasted chance. An opportunity of a lifetime. They want to get unstuck. This person knows that they can make money with you. It says, bring out the gimp from Pulp Fiction. Someone's into the classics, and you could have been born in between 93 and 94. So this person might have been going through certain things in their teenage life between 93 and 94. This person may have been discovering themselves. You know, becoming a young man, a young woman. So this person may have had issues positively dealing with emotions stemming from things that they learned in childhood or from situations or experiences that they went through in childhood. And so this person's been watching you, watching the way that you've wrangled in your emotions. It keeps showing me wrangled. So I don't know whether someone wears Wrangler jeans or someone's a cowboy. But it's just the way you harness your energy, Libra. The way you harness your cups, the many cups that you have, and the way that you fill them. The way that you now move effortlessly with the flow of the universe. Because you were not afraid to stand on the precipice of change. See, some people get stuck, you know. They don't want to change. They'll let things stay upside down or just kind of, you know, just whatever. But you've been able to ground yourself, your emotions, the way you handle them, and the way you allow outside things to affect you. And this Taurus, this Sag, this Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, they've just been watching you. Again, trying to get unstuck, trying to fix or heal childhood traumas. They're trying to better deal with their emotions. They're showing me that one drug commercial back in the day. It's their commercial. And it's like the brother is, like he catches his little brother, like with his, I don't know if it's his pipe. I think he had a pipe and a lighter or a joint or a cigarette or something. And so his brother comes in the room and he's like, where did you learn that from? And he's like, I learned it from watching you, okay? So it's like this person learned how to handle emotions in the way that they've handled them as adult because they did not learn as a youth how to properly process their emotions, their feelings. This person put you up on an altar. This person has put you up on an altar, on a pedestal. Let's see what else is going on. Let's get some oracle messages. Let's see what the guides have to offer about this situation. Yeah, I told you, this person wants to go to dinner, and you may already have dinner plans, Libra. This person wants to take you out. It could be the Sagittarius. Somebody wished you had stayed a little bit longer, Libra. They wish you had stayed a little bit longer. Let's do this. It's a lot of cards. All right, let's see. No. In. So you told this person, you cut off the sex from this person. Because I just saw no in D. Someone could be in Indiana. All right, angels. What messages, what oracle guidance do you have for my Libras concerning this situation? Number three, communication, co-creation. So yeah, we've got communication twice. So it could be this water sign, this Taurus, or it could be this Sagittarius coming in. Again, Libra, you've been in communication with spirit, with your angels, and they have been assisting you, guiding you, telling you to rein in those motherfucking cups, because you are creating something beautiful within yourself that will automatically and naturally, organically, authentically, and sincerely attract what it is to you that you desire. This is a lot of growth. This is a lot of obedience, Libra. So you've been listening to the vibrations from spirit. You've been listening to your guides, and this is what's been helping you blossom. Yeah, this person feels like they are missing out, Libra. Look, heart, their heart has been dropping. They're at the doctor's office. They need help. Number three again. Let's get it. Crystal keys, Libra, you hold the keys. 22, the master builder. You're building, Libra. You're building beautiful flowers in your mind. The intentions that you have been setting. Oh, so effervescent. Peacocks. We have goldfish. Oh, Libras, you're getting many downloads right now. You've also been sending messages out into the universe. So you've been sending out healing vibes, which is why this person is trying to ground themselves, trying to get their shit together. We have bubbles and bubbles. Look at this. As you're bubbling, this person's bubbling. Libra, there is so much focus, so much clarity in your eyes. It's almost scary how much you can see right now. feathers could be significant. Someone here could feel their third eye itching. What else, Angie? Number five. Flying fish. Goldfish. I'm trying to think of the name of this fish. It'll come to me later. It's a specific type of goldfish. Anywho, Libra. Go fish. Libra, you're flying high. Goodness gracious, you're flying high. You're traveling. You're traveling the physical. You're traveling the ethers. You've got new scales. You've got new skin. Your skin is thicker. You feel lighter. Some of you are toning up or toning down. Take it how it resonates. There are butterflies all around you, Libra. Shape-shifting energy, you're a chameleon. See, this is why... this is why your team is so proud of you, because you're such a chameleon, Libra. You can change your skin at any hint of a whim. Anything you desire, you can do in a snap of a finger. You see, it's a butterfly, it's a fish, it's all kinds of things. Libra, you are all kinds of things, be you masculine, feminine, male, female, sir, ma'am, lady, man. You, Libra, you. I'm talking to you, boo. So you may be moving at a snail's pace. Or this person was moving at a snail's pace, Libra. But you were flying high. 11. We have a lot of doubles. 22, 11. 22, 11. Angel number 3. What else? Number 2. And we have 21. So things are coming into order. 21, 22, 11. We have 12. Look at this. The ones and the twos. Libra, things are coming together. I see syntax, I see code. So you're receiving codes. Again, you see the codes, you see the symbols in the bubbles. This is why you're feeling so effervescent. Something happened last night. What happened last night, Libra? This is when shift happens, not shit, Libra. No, Libra, the shit wasn't happening for you. They tried to serve it to you. You said, no, thank you. No, but this is when shift happens, Libra, and the shift is happening for you because you said yes to your higher calling. So of course your DNA strands are being decoded, unlocked, advanced. You're stepping into your power. This is divine feminine energy. Woo, you're smoking hot, Libra. You see this? You see the smoke? Tell me you see the smoke. God dang, Libra, you're so hot. It says, be a human exclamation mark. And Libra, that's what you are. You're bringing out the gimp in people. Libra, you're sucking the gimp, the simp, the pimp out of people. You're sucking it right on out. They don't want to play these games with you anymore because they know just how gosh damn divine you are. You see that? Your whole leg is in the fire. And the light in the unknown, stepping upon your path. This is beautiful energy, Libra. Two more angels for my lovely Libras. Number 3 again. 33. Listen, quit playing. Ether, this is 11 again. I just need y'all to know. First of all, we have 21, 22. Then we have 11, 12, 11. This is 11, 11, Libra. Your twin flame is coming in. I just need y'all to know. Maybe you subscribe to that line of thinking. Maybe you don't. But what I do know, Libra, is somebody definitely is coming in to bring balance. The seamless unspeakable. What did I just say about you traveling? The physical, and the ethers. It came out just for you, Libra. Because you are a magical, mystical empress, emperor, who has many capabilities and natural divine abilities.
you were able to traverse the ethers. You're able to walk through portals, visit different planets, travel to parallel dimensions.
This is no laughing matter, Libra. And you know it. You know that you're a sure thing.
See, people can't easily seduce you, Libra, because you know who the fuck you are.
Yeah, you got your leg out, because, I mean, sun's out, guns out. Some of you gentlemen, some of you masculines here, thank you for joining the channel. I love you.
I appreciate you. Stick around, son. Whether you identify with the masculine or the feminine energies, Libra, this is you clearly stepping into your power, following your divine path, listening to the teachings, receiving the blessings for being obedient to the Most High, for listening to your spiritual team, for knowing when to gather your cups, for knowing how to fill them, and when to serve them for others.
So much balance, Libra, so much power, and you, my dear, my sir, we're just the one to give it to. Someone wants to join your roster, Libra. This is Roster by Jasmine Sullivan playing. Last card. Number six. What do we have? Work through your fears. New moon in Scorpio. So this is Sagittarius, this Taurus, this Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Is really wanting to work through their fears. They may come in a bit defensive, Libra, maybe, because Scorpios have exoskeletons, so this person has had to harden their skin as well. But this person is willing to fight for you. They're willing to see things a different way. They're willing to unstick themselves, because gosh damn it, Libra, you just bring the gimp out of people. You suck it right out of them. They can't come around you simping and pimping and gimping. We're not for that. That whole seduction thing. That whole seduction thing. You're a sure thing, Libra. You know who you are. So people better come correct or not at all. And that's just the real deal. Holy feel. They feeling the pressure, Libra. Reply. Fly. Hi. Can you feel the pressure? You dishing it out, boo. Sir, ma'am, lady, ma'am. Libras, thank you so much for your time, your energy, your watch. Know that I love you. I appreciate you. And Libras, just keep applying pressure. Just keep that same energy. If you would like to request a personal reading, please scroll down in the description box where you will find that information. Libras, please help me, help you, help us grow this channel. Please share these videos. Please like them. Give your girl a thumbs up if it's resonating. Drop some comments down in the comment box. If you would like to contribute monetarily to the growth and the expansion of this channel, you may do so through Cash App, $GirlKing36Tarot. Also down in the description box. Libras, please do use your own intuition and discernment to always make the best decisions for your highest good.
I know that you do. I love you. United we stand. Together we rise. Holla at your girl.